Hey guys, Beth here. I wanted to show you today how I make my pumpkin protein pancakes. I actually posted pictures of this recipe before on the Beast Sports Girl Twitter page, and I always have people asking me how I make them, so I wanted to take the time today to show you guys. The first thing I'm going to start with are 4 egg whites. I always measure mine out, but you don't have to be that picky when you're making yours, but you do want roughly 4 egg whites. From there, I'm gonna add 1/2 scoop of vanilla protein powder. I'm using Beast's protein powder today. As you can see, it's really good. The reason I'm using vanilla though is because the pumpkin really is the star of the show here, and I don't wanna mask it with anything that has a high concentration of flavor. But definitely feel free to play around with different protein powders. You could do chocolate pumpkin, you could do some sort of cinnamon roll, whatever you want to do. I do tend to like the vanilla for this particular recipe. The next thing I'm going to add is oat bran. A lot of people use oats. I prefer either cream of wheat or the oat bran. It gives it a heartier, kind of earthier texture, and I think it's more realistic to what pancake batter will actually feel like as you're eating it. So I'm going to add about 1/4 cup to 1/3 cup here. It doesn't really matter. Either of those two options are fine. And then from here, because we're using pumpkin, I'm going to add some spices that really marry well with pumpkin flavors. I did a little bit of research on some pumpkin bread recipes before I created this recipe, and a lot of them use cinnamon and nutmeg. So I'm going to use both of those here today. I don't ever measure my spices. They're calorie-free, so the sky is the limit, and I like mine really, really pumpkin spicy. The next ingredient I'm going to use, these are Capella flavor drops. I just happen to have these hanging around the house, so I'm going to use them today. These are optional. I think it just kind of heightens the flavor a little bit of the pumpkin that's in this recipe. Tarani also makes a really good sugar-free pumpkin pie syrup that you can put in your coffee that's also really, really good in here. I'm not going to use too much because I don't want it to be an overpowering flavor, but I do think that it adds some good depth to the recipe. The next thing I'm going to add is the star of the show, canned pumpkin puree. This stuff is awesome. It has minimal calories, very few carbohydrates, and it adds a really nice kind of moisture content and thickness to this recipe that I love. I'm going to add about 1/4 cup to 1/3 cup. It's up to you how much you want to put in here. The next thing I'm going to put in is baking powder, not baking soda. Baking soda makes things spread. Baking powder makes things rise. Because I'm a pancake snob, I like my pancakes to be very realistic. So I'm going to add in about 1/2 teaspoon, that's all you need, of baking powder. The very last thing I'm going to add here is Jell-O sugar-free, fat-free cheesecake pudding mix. You can use vanilla pudding mix, whatever flavor you want. If you've done chocolate pumpkin and you've used your chocolate protein powders, you can also use the chocolate sugar-free fat-free pudding mix. And I'm just going to add maybe about 1 teaspoon or 2 in here. So I'm going to mix this all up, and you really want to mix it well before you get it onto your griddle skillet. I usually start with a spoon first, and then we'll get it after it with a whisk to kind of break up all of the chunks in here, because nobody wants chunks in their pancakes. One of the tips I will tell you, what I normally do is I let this sit in the refrigerator overnight because it will thicken up if you give it enough time. Sometimes it can be really runny right off the bat, so allowing it to sit in your refrigerator overnight will give it some good thickness. So once you have that all mixed up, you want to heat up a griddle skillet over medium-high heat. You don't want it to be too hot because you don't want to burn the backside of your pancakes and have them look ugly. You want them to be nice and pretty and golden brown. So I did want to show you, I've already made a batch. I want to show you what the finished product looks like. So these are the pancakes. You can see that they're nice golden brown color on top. They're cooked all the way through. And I usually add some sugar-free syrup to the top of mine. I do like Walden Farms. I also like Hungry Jack sugar-free. It's really, really good stuff. And all of this is about 240 calories. So you get a lot of protein. It's over 30 grams of protein. Minimal carbohydrates and a nice calorie welcome for your morning. So thanks for spending time with me in the kitchen today, guys. I hope you enjoy this breakfast.